Good morning. So today, let me continue with the design of slab type combined footing. So let me brush up what are all the things that I have done in the last class. So in the last class, I was doing the dimension of the footing. Okay, I was doing the dimensions of the footing. So length I have calculated. Okay, then the breadth I have calculated. Still I am in need of the calculation of depth of the footing. Okay, so now what I will be doing is, let me calculate the BMD and SFD for the loading condition given. Okay, so based on that bending moment, I will be providing the depth. Okay, so next heading, it's the BMD and SFD. So BMD and SFD. First, let me write down the beam. So beam is nothing but the slab, I'm telling. It's not beam, it's the slab. Okay, so for every action, there is an equal and opposite reaction from the soil. Okay, so here, the value or the load that they have given is 600 kilonewton. From the boundary line till the center of the first column, the distance is 0.8 meter. Okay, next, there is one more. I think it's 850 kilonewton. The center to center spacing between the columns is 3.5 meter center to center. This one is 1.4 meter. And this upward soil pressure also we have calculated it. So the value is 133.90. This is Q0, which is given by 133.90 kilonewton per meter square. But the problem is, it's an UDL load. Yes or no? So for the UDL, the unit should be kilonewton per meter. So I want to convert this. How to convert it? So multiply it by the breadth. Okay, so what is the breadth? So not this one. This is the boundary condition. I am telling about the length and breadth. So length, it was, so the length of the footing, it was 5.7, and width of the footing, it was 1.9. Let me multiply it with the breadth. So 1.9 meter, it is the breadth of the footing. So it's the breadth of footing I am multiplying. So whatever the design that I am doing, it is same as beam and slab type combined footing. So please be careful. Okay, so what is the value of Q0 that we are getting here? So it's a 254.41. 254.41 kilonewton per meter. Okay, so based on this loading condition, now let me calculate the SFD and BMD. Based on this loading condition, let me calculate the SFD and BMD. So first let me concentrate on the SFD part. So let me give a name, A, B, C and D. So A, B, C and D. Okay, so first let me go with the shear force. So as usual, same procedure, shear force left of A. So shear force calculation. Shear force calculation. So first one is shear force left of A. So obviously left of A, it is zero. Next, shear force right of A. Right of A means just beside this point, so almost that is also zero. Next, shear force left of B. Shear force left of B means just beside this point. So there is an UDL, and as it is acting upward, upward positive, downward negative. So upward, so it's a UDL. I want to convert that into point load. So it is W into L. So W is 254.41. into L is 0.8. So the value that you are getting is, so 254.41, it's 203.53. It's 203.53 kilonewton. Next, I think all these things you people have done it in the SOM, strength of materials, right of B. So right of B means I need to include this point load also. Till here I know the value. So it's 203.53 minus, because the point load is acting in the downward direction, minus 600. So I will be getting around 300 and something. So it's minus 393.47. Minus 393.47 kilonewton. Next, let me go with shear force left of C. So shear force left of C. So observe here, till right of B I have calculated. What is that value? It's minus 393.47. So left of C means this UDL will come into picture. So it's 254.41 into 3.5. So plus 254.41 into 3.5. So the value that we are getting for that is 493.97. 493.97 kilonewton. Next, shear force right of C. So shear force right of C. Left of C, I know the value. So it's 493.97 minus 850. So the value that we are getting here is 356.04. It's 356.04 kilonewton. Next, left of D, shear force left of D. So left of D. So everything we need to consider till right of C, I know it. So it's minus 356.04 till right of C, I know, plus 254.41 into 1.4. So you solve it, you will get the value as 0. Okay, next, right of D, there is no beam at all, I mean no structure. So it's not beam, it's footing. So SF right of D is also equal to 0. So based on this value, first let me write down the SFD diagram. Okay, so now the SFD at A is 0. So SFD at B is 203. So 203, let me mark it here, 203.53. Okay, so as it's a UDL, so it will be linear. So next, right of B, I need to go down. And the value is 393.47. Okay, so next, again it's positive. So it's 493.97 kilonewton. Next, again I need to go down. It's 356.04 kilonewton. At D it is 0. So this will be positive, positive, negative, negative. I think all these things you people know it. And one more thing, wherever the shear force is 0, okay, the bending moment will be maximum at that particular point. Yes or no? So now, so what I will be doing here is, let me start calculating the bending moment also. So I want the bending moment, okay, bending moment calculation. Bending moment calculation. Okay, so moment about A is 0. Moment about D, end point is also 0. I will be calculating what is the moment about B. I will be taking towards left hand side. I mean towards left. So at B, if I take it, so if it hits like this, so it will be sagging moment, so positive. So it's 254.41 into 0.8. 254.41 into 0.8, that will get converted into point load, into 0.8 by 2. So force into perpendicular distance. So the value that we are getting here is, So the value that we are getting here is 81.4 kilonewton meter. 81.4 kilonewton meter. Next, let me go with moment about D point, sorry, not D, about C point. Let me go towards left itself. If you take right also, no problem. So now the entire UDL and it is sagging. So 254.41 into the total distance 3.5 plus 0.8. 4.3 by 2. So next, there is one more point load. So if it acts like this, it's hogging, so negative. Minus 600 into 3.5. So after solving this, the value that we get here, so the value that we are getting here is 249.32. It's 249.32 kilonewton meter. Okay, so as usual, at D and A, we have already calculated it's zero. Now the important thing is, I want first, let me draw a line for the bending moment. This is A, this is B, this is C, and this is D. So at B, we have already calculated, okay? So what is the bending moment at B? It's 81.4 kilonewton. It's 81.4 kilonewton meter. At C also, we have calculated. It's plus 249.32 kilonewton meter. Okay, now the important thing is, wherever you are having the shear force zero, okay, so that point the bending moment will be maximum. So what I will be doing, let me for time being call it as E point. I want the bending moment at this particular junction also. So how to calculate it? So for time being, what I will be doing is, observe here, if I call this as X, can anyone tell me total distance is 3.5? Yes or no? So will you people accept that this will be 3.5 minus X? Yes or no? Because if I want to calculate the bending moment at this point, I want this distance. How to calculate it? Now using the similar triangle concept. So using similar triangle concept, this triangle and this triangle. Observe here. I will be concentrating on these two triangles. So the base of this triangle, instead of calling it as considered and all, so the base of this triangle divided by the height of the triangle is equal to the base of this triangle divided by the height of the triangle, 493.97. So after solving this, the value that we are getting for X is, so after solving for X, so the value that we are obtained is X is equal to 1.55 meter. Okay, so this value I got it now. So what is this distance? So the value of X is 1.55 meter. Now I can calculate what is the bending moment at this junction. So bending moment at E towards left is given by, so UDL, it's 254.41 and it's sagging, 254.41 into 0.8 plus 1.55, 0.8 plus 1.55 into this value by 2. Next, there is one more, minus 600 into perpendicular distance is 1.55. So after solving this, the value that we obtained is 27.51 kilonewton meter. So now let me draw the diagram. So at B, we already know it as it is an UDL, so it will be parabolic. So now at E point, I know the value, just now I have calculated it. It's 227.51 kilonewton meter. So throughout the value is parabolic. Okay, so now the same thing, whatever I have done it in the slab and beam type, the same thing I am doing, nothing else. Okay, I want these two points. I think you people know that where the bending moment changes its sign, that point is called as the point of contraflexure. Okay, so the point of contraflexure, I want that particular point. So what I will be doing is, let me call this as Y1. Okay, now let me call this particular point, okay, as Y2. Then how to calculate this? So for this reason, what I will be doing, so I will be considering this particular junction. I will be considering this particular junction. So I will be calling it as F for time being. Okay, so let me rub all these things. Okay, so now observe here, I will be taking a section over here. Okay, that particular point is F, and we are having a beam here, and it is having an UDL. So the value of UDL is 254.41. Okay, the total distance I don't know, let me call it as Y1. It's Y1. Okay, next we are having a point load, it's 600 kilonewton. I know this is 0.8. Okay, then what about this? Total is Y1 minus 0.8. So it's Y1 minus 0.8. So now what I will be doing is, let me take the moment about this point. So MF is equal to, so I am taking moment about this point. This is sagging UDL. So it's 254.41 into Y1. So that get converted into point load into Y1 by 2. Okay, next, the hogging moment minus 600 into Y1 minus 0.8. But we know that, so MF, so about this point, don't you think that? So the bending moment at that particular point is 0. So I know MF is 0. Please remember, MF is 0. So now 127.205 Y1 square minus 600 Y1 minus 480. So now, after altering this, rearranging this, this is the value that we have obtained. Now, let me rearrange this. So it's 127.205 Y1 square minus 600 Y plus 480 is equal to 0. So now, using the calculator, if we solve for the quadratic equation, you will get two values. That is nothing but the Y1 and Y2. It's 1.02 meter, and the Y2 value that we are obtaining is 3.695 meter. So after solving this using the calculator, just by seeing the diagram, you can understand, you will get two values, 1.02 and 3.695. Just by seeing the drawing, you can understand. So this point can't be 3.695, yes or no, because it is very close to this. So that's why this point needs to be 1.02 meter and this point needs to be 3.695. So we have calculated till there. Why we are doing all these things? Because I want to calculate the depth of the footing. So next I will be going with the depth of footing. So depth of footing calculation. So depth of footing. So how to calculate the depth of footing? 87.36 into XU max by D. It's not MU, it's MU limit. So MU limit is equal to 0.36 XU max by D into 1 minus 0.42 XU max by D into FCK BD square. Okay, so now, what is the value of MU limit that you people want to take? Observe here, which particular value of BMD is highest, will go with that. So as per this particular diagram, so don't you think that 249.32 kilonewton meter is highest? So for that amount of bending, what is the depth that we need to provide? We'll check that. So observe here, so MU limit, okay, but whatever the value that we have got, here, it's only the working value. So, into 1.5 into 249.32. You need to multiply it with 1.5. Okay, be careful with this. Or else you can do one thing. Depth of the footing. So, calculate MU. So, MU is nothing but equal to 1.5 into 249.32. So the value that you are getting there is 373.98. It's 373.98 kilonewton meter. Substitute the same value here. So we'll substitute the same value of mu limit. So it's 373.98 into 10 power 6 is equal to 0.36. As it is Fe415, it's 0.48 into 1 minus 0.42 into 0.48. FCK is 20. Breadth, as it is a footing slab, so it is 1000 into D square. So after solving it for D, so the value that we are getting here is, we are getting is 368.15 mm. So providing, as it is a footing, providing 60 mm effective cover. 60 mm effective cover. So the overall depth will be approximately, I will be making it as 400 mm. So this will be 400 plus 60. So it's 460 mm. So we have calculated the length 5.7 meter of the footing and width 1.9 meter and we have already calculated the depth. So it's 368, we have approximately made it as 400 mm and overall depth is 460 mm. Okay, so next I will be proceeding with the design of footing slab because no beam in this as it is a slab type combined footing. So that design of footing slab, I will be continuing it in the next class. So I will be winding up. Thank you.